It still hangs in the air. The star that saw his face still shines. The song heard at the manger, the angel anthem raised, still echoes through the ages today. Rejoice, peace on earth has come, his favor rests on us, his name is Jesus. Rejoice, the King has come for us, receive what love has done, his name is Jesus. Breaks through the night. Rejoice, peace on earth has come, his favor rests on us, his name is Jesus. Rejoice, the King has come for us, receive one love done, his name is Jesus. He is Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship then, and we be still. His name is Jesus. Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful, they worship then, and we do still. His name is Jesus, Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace. So wonderful, they worship then, and we do still. His name is Jesus.
Hallelujah, amen. Welcome to our service this morning. We're starting off early, just letting you get a feel for our new song that we're going to be doing today. Amen. Isn't it powerful? He is Almighty God. Hallelujah. Emmanuel. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand this morning. Amen. Shofar has sounded. God's power and glory is released in the house this morning. Amen. We are excited. It's our Christmas service today. Welcome to our onliners. Welcome to those of you who are in the house this morning. Best place to be is in the house. You get it firsthand. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Wow. Okay. Glug, glug, glug. Amen. Who's excited to be in the house this morning? Amen. Onliners, I know you're excited to be online. And if you're in Durban, please make your way to DGFC Worship Center, 43 Armstrong Avenue. You know the address. You know the site. You've got a parking spot. It's got your name on it. The Lord's got your number. Amen. And the Lord's got your home address too. So make sure that you're in the house this morning. Amen. We just want to give God glory for this day. We want to give God thanks. We rejoice. We rejoice. We rejoice. We rejoice. We rejoice. We rejoice. Amen. When your soul is feeling downcast, the Lord says, look to me. Amen. Look to me. Look up. Look to me. Let your heart be turned towards me. Amen. Today we are so excited. We're so excited about the food. We're so excited about the word. The food in all respects, actually. We're excited about God. Amen. You know what? Give yourselves a hand for pressing through. Give yourselves a hand for pressing through. It's been a tough year, amen? But how many of us can say we've developed some spiritual muscle in this time and season, amen? And so Jesus wants for us to do. Jesus wants us to grow. Jesus wants us to be those who know what it is to be in the army of God, amen? And to rejoice. Peace on earth has come. God's favor rests on us. Shikabasataba. For he is Emmanuel, God who is with us. Amen. Power of God living in each and every single one of you. Power of God. Power to change environments. Power to make declarations and speak things into being. Believe and know that God is God. Amen. Hallelujah. I actually don't even want to go through the notices. I've sent them out. We're here to celebrate the season. We know that Jesus wasn't born in December. Amen. That's a whole other teaching. Apostle, bring it, I'm sure, at some stage. Oh, well, or me. Amen. But we celebrate corporately. This is the time that's kind of allotted on the Roman calendar where we celebrate the birth of Jesus. But we know in our heart that we're spoiled. We get to celebrate Jesus' birth twice. Amen. Some say that Jesus was born sometime in late September. And it's kind of interesting, Apostle, it's the Jewish New Year. Well, it's our New Year. We celebrate that. Amen. And that's what they say. Some of the research that we've done and what Apostle has taught us, sometime September, October, Jesus was born. Amen. So it is so exciting. It really is. Let's stand. We're going to enter into some amazing Christmas worship this morning. But first, we're going to pray. I think Apostle's going to say something.
I was just going to call a prophet to come and pray for us. Let's just raise our hands. Pastor Branden, thank you so much. How can we not be excited after that intro? So Lord Jesus, we just praise and glorify your name this morning, for we have much to be thankful for and grateful for. We come into agreement this morning, Lord God, with a spirit of joy, Lord God, rising up within us, Lord God. It doesn't matter what we see around us, Lord God, or the storms that might be raging about us, Lord God. But one thing we know is that you are faithful. You are Emmanuel. You are God with us. And Jesus, this morning we celebrate your name. Lord. Your mighty name will be declared upon all the earth, thank Lord you, God. And thank you that you are invading homes right now, Lord God, to bring, Lord God, a spirit of joy upon us in the name of Jesus. So right now we rise, Lord God, in the spirit of joy, knowing that we can worship you, Lord God, in spirit and in truth, in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Joy to the world. Amen. Come on, you've got to. Who's experiencing joy in this place this morning? Thank you. Amen. Worship to the fullest.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive its King. Let every heart sing, and heaven and nature sing.
joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let people their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. God rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of God's righteousness, and wonders of God's love, and wonders of God's love, and wonders of God's love. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all the nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with angelic woos proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord. Late in time, behold him come, offspring of the virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see. Hail the incarnate deity. Pleased as God with us to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that we no more may die. Born to raise us from the earth, born to give a second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Oh, come, holy faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come me, oh, come me to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him in Christ the Lord. Singing choirs of angels, singing exaltation, sing, holy citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, oh, glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord. All hail, Lord, we greet thee on this happy morning. O Jesus, forevermore be thy name adored. Word of our parents, now in flesh appearing. O come, let us adore. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore.
Hallelujah, come on. Amen. Let us adore him. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. His name shall be Wonderful Counselor, mighty God, high and lifted up. Sing this song with us this morning. His name shall be.
Of God's smile, the glory of God's face. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, your children sing. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor. Come on, church. Mighty God, Everlasting Savior, Prince of Peace for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Savior, Prince of Peace for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be. He came to lift the weary ones, give peace and perfect rest. Thank you, Lord, to take away our burdens and to give a glorious gift. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the world will sing. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Savior, of peace for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Savior, Prince of Peace for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be. One name above all others. One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name. One name above all others. Come on, church, just sing it out. One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name is. His name is Jesus. Come on, one name above all others. We can declare it this morning. Hallelujah, Jesus. One name above all others. Come on, lift your hands this morning. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing
His name is, His name is Jesus. One name, Jesus. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name is, His name is Jesus. His name shall be wonderful.
Come on, church, sing it out. Everlasting,
everlasting Savior, Prince of Peace for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be. Oh, His name shall be. Oh, His name shall be. His name shall be.
Come on, one name above all others.
One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name is, His name is Jesus.
Come on, let's declare it this morning. It's so powerful, the name of Jesus.
One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name is, His name is Jesus.
One name above all others. Come on, church. Hallelujah, Lord. We sing it out this morning.
One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name is, His name is Jesus.
One name, Lord, oh Jesus.
One name above all others. One name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name is, His name is Jesus.
Your hands this morning, the glory and the wonder, the glory and the wonder, it still hangs in the air. The name of Jesus.
Receive one love has done His name is Jesus.
Come on, heaven's hope.
Heaven's hope awakened with the baby's cry. Still his voice breaks through the night. Rejoice, peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus.
Come on, rejoice.
Rejoice, King has come for us. Receive what love has done. His name is Jesus. He is Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship them and we do still. His name is Jesus, Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship them, and we do still. His name is Jesus, Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship them, and we do still. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus.
Come on, church, rejoice this morning.
Rejoice, the King has come for us. Receive one love raised on. His name is Jesus.
Rejoice, rejoice.
Rejoice, peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, the King has come for us. Receive what love has done. His name is Jesus. He is Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship them, and we do still. His name is Jesus, Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship them, and we do still. His name is Jesus, Almighty God, Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, so wonderful. They worship them, and we do still. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus.
Come on, church. His
name. Rejoice, the King has come for us. Receive what love has done. His name is Jesus.
His name,
his name, his name. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus.
Rejoice, peace on earth has come. Peace on earth will remain. Lift your hands right now, please.
Peace on earth has come. The word says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they will inherit the kingdom of God. How many of you are peacemakers this morning? Peace in your heart, in your life. Jesus, restorer, healer, deliverer, almighty God. Glory, glory, glory. A holy night.
Voices, oh, night. divine. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 There is a moment here. Thank you, Jesus. Fall on your knees and worship.
Yes.
Fall on your knees and worship. Christ divine. Yeshua. Yeshua. Yeshua.
Just lift your hands right now. Everyone in this place. Everyone watching online. We're just here to worship you, Jesus. It's always been about you, and it always will be about you. It's not about the date you were born. It's about why you were born. And you came to this earth so that every single one of us could have life, so that every one of us could be set free from bondage, so that every one of us could know what it is to experience a love divine, to experience a love that comes from above, that purifies our hearts, that forgives so easily, that holds no grudges, that takes away the sin of the world. For that love divine came and touched my life one night when I was 10 years old. That love came from on high when I'd backslidden for 10 years, leaving you out of my life. That love divine came and never forgot about who I was and the calling on my life that I had forsaken. That love divine never forgot about who I was because of who you are. We fall on our knees. Shiramande kibaso, hikabasonde hime, shondorobako bashatai, pokose hime. For I hear the cry from the heart, says the Lord. I'm never too busy to hear the cry of the heart. It's the heart cry that turns the ear of the Savior. It's not just words, but the heart cry. Whatever your heart cry is this morning, whatever your heart cry is, what is deep inside of you, whatever you've been praying out to the Lord for this morning, God hears you, child of God. God hears you. God knows your pain. God knows your anguish. God knows your betrayal. God knows the struggles that you're going through. Every single person. Hey, I'm not without my own struggles. I'm not without my own betrayals. But I'm called to stand. Called to stand. And I will stand for you, Lord. Because you died for me. You came to this earth. And you were born to die. So that I could have life abundant. The scars on my back could never compare with the scars that you bore for me. And this morning, Lord, we come. We fall upon our knees, Lord, in spirit this morning, realizing the privilege it is to serve you, realizing the privilege it is to have a house like this, realizing the privilege it is to be part of a family of God that loves and cares and nurtures and wants to see the best in people, wants to see people thrive, because that's your heart for us. Because that's your heart for us, Lord. I hear the Lord saying that the days of mourning are coming to an end. I hear the Lord saying, rise up, my children, for it is not just about a calendar new year, but it is about rising up in the hope of what I have promised. It's about rising up in the hope
that has been set before you, not the eyes of the flesh, but the eyes of your heart and spirit. For I am raising up an army who are taking the forefront in the battle lines. And these are people that will not stop. The Lord would say, these are people that are not afraid to be on the front lines. These are people that are not afraid of the bullets of the enemy, because they carry with them the shield of faith. And they are the ones that will go into 2019. The Lord says, I want to tell you, it is not about physical strength this morning. It's not about what you can endure in the physical. It's not about what you can endure just in the understanding of your carnality. It's about what you know I can do in my strength for you. It's about knowing that no matter what battle you go through, no matter what front lines you're on, I stand before you. I go before you, just as I did when my servant David took up those stones and slew the giant. There are giants in the land that come and they intimidate and they pull down and they ridicule you. But the Lord would say, stand tall, my servant, because I go before you. You go in the strength of a lion, because the Lion of Judah goes before you. The God of the supernatural is still the God of the supernatural. And the season of mourning is coming to an end, the Lord would say. Joy is coming in the morning. Joy is coming in the morning. Joy is coming in the morning. Lift up your heads and see what I will show you is to come. That name is wonderful. That name is so wonderful. The name of Jesus. When we were singing that song, I just couldn't move away from the power of that name. The anointing just came all over me, because I just experienced just the power of that name. His name is so wonderful. Do you know the magnitude of His name for you this morning? It's the name above every other name. It's the name to which every knee will bow. He's wonderful counselor. Isaiah 9 speaks about Him as victorious before we even go into the New Testament. And Christ was victorious for us so that we could be victorious in Him. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a shout this hallelujah. Morning. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. 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 I think at this point, Pastor Brand looks like he's ready to preach. So I'm going to ask you all, just in the spirit and the anointing that is in this place, just to be seated. Maybe greet one another with a holy kiss. But you don't have to kiss, just hug and tell somebody God loves you. Good to see you here. Amen. Wonderful to see all of you. And all for those online, we just want to say welcome to our Christmas service this morning. We are so delighted to have you with us. You are part of our family, no matter where you are watching from in the world, or in a joined family somewhere to one of the churches or networks we're affiliated with. And we just want to bless you in the name of Jesus and welcome you onliners as well this morning. And I'm going to just hand over to Pastor Brand now, because I can see there's just a message burning within his spirit and in his heart. And so, Lord, I thank you. I thank you for the word that you're going to speak. Thank you that as you speak through Pastor Brand, the power of that name shall be manifest and made known to every person. Lord, made known in us first, the power of that name, in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody shouted, hallelujah, amen.
Thank you, Apostle. Hallelujah. I'm so excited, and I feel so privileged to be able to bring a Christmas message today. This is the first time I've been able to do this in the 15 years that I've been with DGFC, so I'm very excited. And God's been speaking to me probably about the last 2 weeks about the name of Jesus. Amen. What's in a name? And you know, like when God is speaking to you, especially for me, I wake up weird hours of the morning, and I've got this like thing in my head, what's in a name? And the Lord kind of gives me my sermon titles that way. And so I knew the Lord was saying something to me about this. And at that stage, Apostle and I hadn't spoken about doing the Christmas message. So I was quite excited when we had the chat, and I thought, okay, God definitely wants me to do something with this. Hallelujah. So I have come to bring you hark good news. Hallelujah. Hark good news about Jesus. Amen. How many of you want to be heralds? Not an angel. Hallelujah. Well, that's a whole other theology going on there. But how many of you want to be heralds? A herald is someone who runs with the word. Someone who proclaims the word of God. Amen. Okay, everyone's hand should be up now. Hallelujah. So hark the heralds.
Amen.
Amen. Hark the heralds of the Lord. Write it down and run with it. Amen. Make the vision plain and clear. Write it on the tablet of your heart. Amen. And there was a vision that God had for humanity. That was a vision of restoration, and is a vision of restoration. It was not past tense, it's present tense, it's future tense. Amen. So this is the Christmas message today that I have for you. Please open your word to Luke chapter 1, verse 30 to 33. And for a change, I'm going to read out of the good word definition, translation at least. How many of you know that God's word is good? Luke 1, verse 30 to 33. Luke 1, verse 30 to 33. Okay, all right. The angel told her, and this is the angel talking to Mary, "Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will become pregnant, give birth to a son, and name him Jesus. He will be a great man, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. Your son will be king of Jacob's people forever, and his kingdom will never end." And when I was going through this scripture, I was imagining Mary sitting there in the field, and this angel appears to her and starts speaking to her. Kind of the feelings that would be going through her, excitement, nervousness. The angel says to her, "You have found favor with God." Now, Mary may not have known that. I don't think she was someone who was kind of consumed with herself, amen? But she found favor with God, and so she was blessed. She was blessed, and she was going to give birth to a son, the scripture says, "And you shall name him Jesus." Isn't that interesting? The angel said, "You shall name him Jesus." It's not like Mary had a choice, amen? And there's something very, very significant in that. The angel spoke into Mary's life words about the event that would change the future of humanity forever and ever. Amen. People didn't know it at the time, but these words that were spoken had a ripple effect. You see, whenever God does something on the earth, the Lord always does a demonstration of that. When God releases a word, when God does something on the earth, there's always a demonstration of that. And the Spirit is taking me somewhere else right now with this. So I'm just going to go with it. You know what happens when the Spirit of God begins to release things on the earth? The enemy gets a little bit uptight. He gets a little bit irritated. He gets a little bit agitated. Amen? But the people of God begin to rise up even more in authority and power. Hallelujah. So in Jesus, when those words are spoken out, can you imagine the effect that it had on the enemy? Here comes the Savior of the world. His name is Jesus. The Hebrew says in the original text, his name is Yeshua, which is actually derived from the name Joshua, which means Joshua. Amen. And that means to save or to be the Savior. There's some theology for you. Amen. Didn't say Jesus. His name is Yeshua. We say Jesus, but there were many names in those days called Jesus, but he was the only one called Jesus the Christ, Jesus the Messiah, Jesus the Savior. Amen. And so what happened is when the angel spoke these words out, there was a ripple effect that was taking place on the earth because the enemy had dominion over the earth. Even though the Lord said in Genesis, "I give you dominion over the earth, over the animals, over the air, over everything." But when humanity sinned, we know what happened. Obviously, that dominion was taken away. Jesus came to restore dominion. Jesus came to restore power to humanity. Jesus came to bring restoration to our relationship with God. That's the Christmas message. You can't have the birth of Jesus. An apostle has spoken about this before. You can't have the birth of Jesus without recognizing the name of Jesus, without recognizing the cross of Jesus, without recognizing the resurrection of Jesus. All of those going together confirm the supernatural work of God. aside from each other, they're great stories. Amen. But together they make one powerful impact on the earth. Hallelujah. And you know what? That impact goes from generation to generation. The word says that one generation will tell it to another generation. Hallelujah. What the enemy does is the enemy likes to come and he likes to attack those who are rising up in the Lord, those whose faith is rising up, because he knows that those will be the ones who will take that story from generation to generation. He knows that they will be the ones that will be the heralds of the Lord. He knows that they are the ones who will rise up in great power and in authority. And that when the power of God moves on the earth, those people will be the ones that will be counted as the generals of God in the spirit. Hallelujah. Come on, someone. Hallelujah. We need to stop saying, oh, the enemy is doing this to me. Oh, the enemy is doing that to me. You know what happens to us when that happens? Is there a spirit that begins to attach itself to us? It is a spirit that brings you down. Jesus said in John 10:10, we've got it written up over here, typed over there, to bring restoration to the healing power of Christ. Christ has come to give us supernatural abundant life. Amen. But when we let the enemy get into our thoughts, we begin to diminish the power of God in our life. Sure. And if you think the enemy is not original, see what he's been doing in our lives. Don't focus on it. But I want to show you, I want to paint you a picture of what he did when the angel said to Mary, you will give birth to a son and his name shall be Jesus. Do you know that there was a Jewish king called Herod at the time? He had a dream about this boy who would become king. And it was a prophecy. How many of you know that the Old Testament is a prophetic word about what is to come in the New Testament? How many of you know that? It's not just a great story. It's not just included there because it's a great read. You know, we know there's been many movies being made about the Old Testament. Ben-Hur, you know, is that right? I think so. I don't know. It might be not. Apostle Ben-Hur, is it from? Okay, they took some of the stuff from there. Okay, disclaimer. All right. Rub that from the screen, et cetera, et cetera. Amen. But there have been many stories that have been written about the Old Testament. This is why it's important to know your word. Movies like Noah and all those things. I mean, some of those things will really twist your theology. Amen. You've got to know the word of God. But the point is that the Old Testament was a prophetic word about what was to come in the New Testament, about what God was to release. Go read the book of Isaiah. An amazing book. Amazing book. It foretells the coming of Jesus Christ. The one who would save the people from their sins. That's what the word of God says. Amen. Let's get back to King Herod. So he had a dream about this boy. And there was a prophetic word about him. And he got scared. So he called his astrologers and his theologians and whatever's. Amen. And he said, tell me about this boy. But there were the three. You know what? Actually, this is interesting. When I was researching it, we always think that there were three wise men. It doesn't say anything about three wise men. It doesn't say anything about three wise men. It's just kind of like people just put that in there. It said wise men. But somehow we kind of got three wise men. You know? And you know how we got that? This is a bit of background teaching here. Because there were only three gifts that were given. That's what we read about. So we think there were three wise men. I was blown away. I was like, say what? You know? Talk about wrecking my theology and my understanding of the word of God. So there weren't three wise men. But anyway, so King Herod calls for the wise people, the wise men. Okay, they were men. Let's just call it what they are. Amen. Call a spade a spade. Amen. So he calls for the wise men. And he says to them, tell me, where is this boy going to be born? Because I want to worship him. You see how the devil comes. He comes with almost like a sense of sincerity. But it's shrouded. It's shrouded. You've got to have discernment in this time. Tell me where the boy is going to be born so that I can go and worship him. Now, these are the wise men. I mean, no, they were called the Magi. Magi. Amen. So they didn't tell him where Jesus would be born, but they went to worship. They followed a star. And some of the research that I was doing, it took 2 years, apparently, to get to where Jesus was. I don't know if that's true or not. I have to go do a bit more research on that. But they went on a journey to worship. They were authentic in their worship. Amen. And so when they found Jesus, they began to worship and they bowed down low. And the word for that in the Hebrew is proskuneo. That means to come before the Lord with the intention to kiss. This is a love story. When Jesus was born, it was a love story that was in the making. You think about Romeo and Juliet being the greatest love story. I mean, that's the greatest tragedy. But the birth of Jesus Christ and what he went through is the greatest love story ever. And many of us are here today because of that love story. Many of us have found healing, deliverance because of that love story. So here were these three wise men, and they were presenting gifts to Jesus, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And they worshipped. It was part of their worship. It was their sacrifice. It was their offering. They didn't know his name was Jesus at the time. Mary hadn't disclosed that to anyone. Only Joseph knew that. Can you imagine, as a parent, the power and the privilege it is to name your child? There is something that is authentic in that. There's something so powerful in it. And I'm going to get to that just now. I'll talk about that. I'm busy digressing a little bit on my message here. But they began to worship Jesus, and that was a prophetic act of what was to come today, for generations to come, where we would come into the house of God, and Jesus said, no longer will we worship on this mountain. Amen. So our worship is not restricted to the four walls. We come together corporately to celebrate and worship Jesus. But it was prophetic of what was to come of our worship today. We would come and we would bow down and we would give our gifts to the Lord. How many of you know that you are the gift that Jesus created, that God created? You are the gift. Sometimes we don't see ourselves like that. We lose our identity. You know, at some point in our journey, we lose our identity. We lose who we are. But to God, identity is so important. We know that God is called the Great I Am. And you know that the early Jewish people held that in such high regard. God's name was never spoken out of turn. You know, and today, and it's actually quite interesting how the name of Jesus is used as a kind of like a cuss word, if I can use it like that. You know, my spirit cringes when I hear people using the name of Jesus in vain, because as Christians, well, certainly those who are born again Christians, when you are in an environment and someone's using the name of Jesus as a kind of a sort of a flip word, sorry, Apostle, profanity, that's the word, thanks. Using it as a word of profanity, my spirit absolutely cringes. And you want to know why? Because my spirit knows the power of that name. My spirit witnesses with the power of that name. And so I will stand up and I'll say, please do not use the name of Jesus in vain. I don't care where you are. You know, some people, you need to have respect, because that name has value. That name is powerful. It holds value. Amen? I need to give you some things here. The enemy is afraid of your rebirthing. How many of you know that when you are born again, you're given a new name? You'll obviously have your Christian name as such, but you're given the name of Jesus. It's tattooed on your heart. When you say yes to Jesus and he comes into your life, you're born into the family of God. And so you get given the name, the son and the daughter of the Most High God. You're renamed. Amen. Apostle brought a word a couple of years ago from Isaiah 62, verse 4. Let me read the scripture to you. No longer will they call you deserted, or your name desolate, but you will be called Hephzibah. The Lord will take delight in you, and your land will be married. How many of you knew that your name had been renamed? And the secret, it's written in the word actually, Isaiah 62 verse 4. Your name is Hephzibah, which means that God delights in you. That is exciting news. So many of us, I think, when we're going through life, we wish we weren't born with the name we were given. Amen? For some of us, it's because we haven't healed from past issues in our life. You know, our parents would call our name and we'd get a hiding for something. So whenever your name was called, you would go and run and hide. Can you please call someone else's name? Not my name this time. But listen, it's not unoriginal. There were many people that ran from the Lord when God called their name. Hallelujah. But how many of you know that God is calling the prodigals back into the house of God? Through the name of Jesus. God is calling the prodigals back into the house. And there are many who have been prodigals because of wherever they've been and whatever ministry they've been in, whatever church, whatever house you've been in. You may have become a prodigal because you were told you couldn't be gay and serve the Lord. Listen, Jesus' birth was for everyone. It wasn't for a select few people. It was for you. It was for me. It was for the person on the street. It was for the person in that Woolies queue. Amen. Or Checkers. Pick and pay. Amen. It was for every single person. Is the power of the name of Jesus. You know, there is something that is stirring in the atmosphere right now, and I don't know what it is. Prophet, something is happening here this morning. There is the Lord is going to redefine some things in our mind about who we are in the Lord and what the name of Jesus represents to us and in us. For the Lord says, I'm redefining how you see me. I'm redefining how you walk your walk. I'm redefining your house. Yes. For there is a new wave of glory that God is releasing. There is a new impact that my people will be making in the season to come, says the Lord. For when you lay your hands on things, there will be change. There will be a shift. When you speak the words from my word, there will be a shift. There will be a change. For does not my word not create? Says God. You can open your eyes. If your eyes were closed. There is a new creation that God is doing in the people of God. We keep hearing about this new breed arising. Jesus was the original breed that was born on the earth. He was the original intent of God. Amen. And the enemy will increase in counterfeit. We need to be aware of that in the season to come. The enemy will increase in counterfeit, but you need to have wisdom and discernment. Walk closely with the Lord. Walk closely with the Lord. And as Jesus begins to be redefined in your life, because some of us, we need a redefinition of what Jesus is and who he is in our life. When Jesus is redefined in your life, you will know that he's the one who's the healer, who is the deliverer. He is the one who sets free. He is Almighty God. He is Emmanuel, God with us, as we were singing in that song this morning. No longer will you be called deserted, as Isaiah 62 verse 4 says. Come on, there's a word of filling here that God wants to do this morning with you. A filling up. Jesus grew up in 30 years, amen, and he started his ministry. For some people, the Lord calls them at 10, apostle. For some of you, the Lord calls you at 12. For some of you, God is restoring dreams to when God spoke to you years and years ago, and somehow those dreams were snatched away from you as you began to walk through this journey called life. Do you know that Jesus was with you every step of that way? And he's met you to this point today. Some of us have been through tsunamis in our life. But yet Jesus has still remained Jesus. He has still remained the same. Amen. I've got so many things to say to you today, and I don't know where to go here. Apostle said this earlier in Isaiah 59 verse 1, the Lord's hand is not too short to save. Amen. God's not deaf. God is hearing. God hears the cry of God's people. That's why Jesus came. Whenever there is a cry from the people of God, God comes. Amen. And there were many that were raised up in the Bible when you read through it that came to be the deliverers of the people of God. But it's amazing for me how many people had to be raised up for the people to finally actually get it. And even when Jesus came, some of the people didn't get it. Mantles were dropped. Amen. Some of the people just did not get it. Yeah, we are 2,000 and something years later, and we still don't get it sometimes. You know, it's like God is saying, what more must I do? What more must I do? Jesus is there. That's why we've got to recognize the power and authority of Jesus in our life. Recognize the power and authority of that name of Jesus. It is the name to which every knee will bow. It is the name that when you pray over someone, that person is healed. It is that name when you pray over someone, they are delivered. They are set free. Do you know that as a ministry, when we pray, oh my word, when we as a ministry pray, we pray in the name of Jesus. We don't pray in the name of the speaker or whatever, Amen. People want to talk about cults and things like that. Read the word of God. See the fruit in the life of the people of God. Amen. I get so mad when I see things like that because people don't know what they're talking about. And they do damage to the house of God. Amen. Yes. There is almost like these echoes that kind of go through the ages, you know. Jesus has always had echoes coming against him through the ages. The people of God have always had echoes. Those that would bring doubt. When Jesus came, because God said it in the Old Testament, I'm going to bring someone who's going to deliver you. I'm going to bring someone who's going to be the deliverer. That was the word spoken in truth. And when Jesus was born, there was those who would come as the doubters, as the mockers. Amen. Jesus said, be gone. Be gone with you. And Jesus said, I've given you the power and authority to stamp upon the heads of snakes and scorpions. You can do everything in my name, Jesus said. Amen. Sure. Proverbs 22 verse 1 says, a good name is more desirable than great riches. All of us want to have a good name. Amen. We want to be known for doing something good on the earth. But there'll always be those that come who will try and tarnish that name, will come and bring down the work of God, will try and bring down that person of God. There will always be that. It's kind of like, it's almost a given, you know. But we, as the people of God and the house of God, don't have to stand for that. Why? Because Jesus is seated on the throne of this house. Jesus is seated on the throne of our lives. Amen. So what is in a name? What difference does it make? What difference does a name make? Some of us are embarrassed of our names. Some of us are. Let's be honest here. We are embarrassed of our names. We wish we would have been born with a different name. For whatever reason, that name sounds great. There is something so specific in the name that your parents have given you. There is something so specific about the name of Jesus. Do you know that he was only called Jesus Christ after he was crucified? The Christ. Jesus the Christ. They even put it on Jesus' cross, King of the Jews. We call him King of our heart today, King of our lives, King of the restoration in our lives. I'm excited to be here today because I have Jesus tattooed in my heart. Sometimes that name got a bit blurred because of my own issues and the hurt and the pain and all the other drama that goes with life, you know. But Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. So I want to tell you something today, that when you're experiencing that what might not be considered life, ask yourself, where is Jesus seated in the place of your life? I'm telling you now, you can go through the treadmill, the sawmill, rather. You can go through the sawmill. You can go through the tough times, but where is Jesus seated in your heart today? Where is he seated? He's got to be seated in that place of the throne of your heart, in that place of authority. Amen? I love Apostle, you actually wrote this on Facebook about what Apostle Maldonado said about the name of Jesus. Apostle Maldonado says this, when you pray in the name of Jesus, there are places that are under the authority of his name. The heavens, the earth, and under the earth. Can you see that there are places that are on earth, under the earth, and in the heavens that are under the authority of the name of Jesus? Everything is under the authority of the name of Jesus. For he is the word that was spoken to life. Amen. And so when we're on this earth and we're walking this earth, everything on this earth, under the earth and in the heavens, is under subjection to the name of Jesus. We lose sight of that. We lose sight of the significance of the name of Jesus. We always remember the birth of Jesus. We remember the crucifixion. We remember the resurrection, because those are all things that we know. We have life through that, but we forget about the name of Jesus. The Bible says that God equips us with every good and perfect gift. Amen. We forget about the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Jesus says, when you pray, pray through my name. The Lord's Prayer ends with in Jesus' name. Well, in amen. Amen. Can't forget about the power of the name of Jesus. And I want to give you some biblical reasons for that. If I can just get at you. Of why names are so important. Here we go. You have to understand the significance. So number one, a biblical name could record some aspect of a person's birth. So that is the nature of a person's birth. And some of our cultures in South Africa, when parents name their children, it's also about kind of the nature of the person's birth. Especially in the Zulu culture, I know that when a child is named, it's named because of the nature of the birth. And the second one is sometimes a biblical name expressed the parents' reaction to the birth of their child. These are all reasons why biblical names are so important. Number three, biblical names were sometimes used to secure the tightness of family ties. So we are all tied together by the name of Jesus, with cords that cannot be broken. Three-corded strand. Amen? Don't worry to write that down. If you want them, I can give it to you afterwards. I'm going quickly here. Biblical names could be used to communicate God's message. Jehovah Jireh, the provider. Jehovah Rapha, the healer. Come on, you got to know these names. Jehovah Nissi. And the other one, I can't say it. Jehovah Tisknu, I think it is. I think you pronounce it like that. I think there's six names, actually. Can't remember them all right now. Number five, biblical names were used to establish an affiliation with God. And the enemy hates this one. It's used to express or establish an affiliation with God. Number six, biblical names were given to establish authority over another, or to indicate a new beginning or a new direction in a person's life. Remember Abraham or Abram was renamed Abraham. God has the authority to change a name. Yes, we have laws governing on our land here that you can change your name, but what is the impact that that's going to have in your life. Jesus wants you to know that through your rebirthing, there is a rebranding. When you're rebirthed, you're rebranded into the kingdom of God. You're rebranded as a son or daughter of the Most High God. And you see yourself at that manger when Jesus was being born, knowing that his birth ultimately was going to result in you having everlasting life. The Lord gave me these yesterday. I need to give them to you as well, very quickly. Some good news for you today. The birth of Jesus, this was the groundwork to your salvation. His death on the cross and his blood being poured out was and is the key to your salvation. His resurrection to life was and is your resuscitation to life. His Holy Spirit was and is the fuel for your journey. If you want these, I'll give them to you afterwards. I'm going quickly. His name, the thing that we've been speaking about today, that is so precious, it's so powerful, it's so absolute. It's the binding, it's the loosing. It's the name that delivers, it's the name that heals, it's the name that sets free, it's the name that reestablishes, it's the name that restores, makes new, makes whole. And when you go through really tough times, sometimes you lose yourself in those tough times. But the Lord is saying to you today, remember my name. Remember my name that is a banner over you, and that is a name of love, that is a name of healing and deliverance. We've got to express that name more and more every single day. Close your eyes for a minute, please, for a couple of seconds. Do you know that when Jesus was born, he already saw your name. It was already written. When he went through his ministry on this earth, he was thinking about you and I. He was thinking about the generations to come. He already knew those that would become those that would fall away. And his heart broke for that. But yet he still went to the cross. And as he was hanging on that cross, after going through a time of really bad and terrible persecution, he still saw your name. He looked into the heavens and he saw the future that was to come. And he saw that what he was to do at that point in time was to bring deliverance and healing to you and I. And yet he still went through it. And even in our faults, even in our betrayals, he still loves us. But he wants us to heal and he wants us to be found in his presence. He wants us to be found in God's presence. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Kiarabashanda. Wodebeshende. Prendi de Bishinda Rabasundo Roboshe Rabakasurbushu. Preste de Biarabashundo Roboseke Rebesha Babasiti Kiabasha. Kositi under Abashanda Rabasukushu Rebese. What has happened to us as God's people? The moment we give our life to the Lord, we rejoice. We find happiness. We find healing. We find peace. And as we go through life and we get battered by the sea and the waves and everything else, we kind of lose what God has done in our life and what God is doing. The Lord is saying today, stop thinking about those things from the past that we keep kind of fixating on. Do you know that that is a trap from the enemy? When we fixate on the things from the past, I did this wrong. Oh, I failed at that. I lost this. I lost that. There are seasons in our life when we go through things that sometimes things have to be lost for a reason. Otherwise, we don't actually move into where God wants us to be. Amen? Be very careful with that, though. Don't take what I'm saying right now as an excuse to kind of run from the Lord or run from the house that God has planted you in or run from whatever challenge the Lord's giving you to work through. Don't use it as an excuse. Jesus isn't a crutch at the end of the day. Amen? His name is something that lifts up. Amen. It restores. Peter and John, when they went to go pray at the temple, there was a man sitting outside the temple who couldn't walk. And the guy was asking for alms or for money. And they said, silver and gold have I nothing, but such as I have give I to thee. And in the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk. And the Lord is saying to some of us today, in my name, rise up and walk. In my name, rise up and walk. In my name, let go of the past. In my name, in Jesus' name, let go of everything that hinders you, everything that ties you down, that holds you back, that becomes a stumbling block in your life. Let go of it now in Jesus' name. That birth was about deliverance. We sing that song, Mary, Did You Know? Well, we don't sing it, but there's a song that goes, Mary, Did You Know? That this baby boy that you deliver will someday deliver you. It's not just a name that we sing about. We've been singing these amazing songs today. But there has been an anointing. There has been a power as we've been singing the name of Jesus. There is something in the melody, yes, but there's words. The power in the words that we're singing. Power in the name of Jesus. For some of us today, I can just, looking at some of the faces here, the Lord is showing me that some of us need to find some joy in our life again. We've been so held back. And look, it's been a tough year. We know that. I mean, that's like old news. I mean, the Herald's already gone with that news. And kind of like, wow, you're still stuck on. It's been a tough year. You know, the Herald's are now saying Jesus has come and Jesus is gone. And my spirit is here, says the Lord. Wow, we're still stuck on the old news. Yes, break the distractions. Amen. Come on, lift your hands right now. Jesus, Lord, you see every hand that is raised here this morning. God, every hand that is hungry for you, God. Lord, every life that is seated in this place this morning. And God, I speak through the power of the name of Jesus that a wave of your love and a wave of your deliverance would come in and rest in this place today. Holy Spirit, that you would move, that you would move in this place today in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, restore lost relationships. God, restore lost joy in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Lord, restore lost identity. And God, renew identity in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Can I ask the band to come up, please? In Jesus' mighty name. There is something that the Lord is doing right now in this place. There is an anointing that is moving. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. And I speak to every spirit of unbelief right now, every spirit of doubt, be broken in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. If you want to receive from the Lord this morning, there is a faith step that you've got to take. You've got to come to the altar. You've got to come and worship the Lord this morning. You've got to come and worship the Lord this morning. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Please stand. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus. Come on, church. Stretch out your hands to the Lord this morning. God's love and God's peace and God's power is in this place today. There is a setting free anointing that the Lord has for you this morning. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. It doesn't matter what's happened in the past. It doesn't matter what you've been going through. The Lord's saying, where do you want to go to? Where do you want to go to this morning? I'm going to call you up. I'm not going to call you up by name unless the Lord specifically says that to me. And prophet, do you want to minister with me? Let the Holy Spirit do what the Holy Spirit wants to do today. Christmas message is about deliverance and healing. It's about emptying of self, emptying of ourself, and it's about allowing more of God to come in. The two young girls at the back that came with Snare, are they family of yours? Can you bring them up, please? Yeah, if they're comfortable. If you're comfortable coming up.
Too late.
Snare, do you want to come with them? Come with them. You know, as I was standing here and I was watching the two of you, the Lord was showing me the two of you.
Saw this earlier, so thank you. Be blessed in Jesus' name. So what I saw earlier too is that the Lord's going to give us, and Pastor Branden brought a very powerful word about almost having a revelation of the name of Jesus. That for some of us, that name used to bring condemnation. That name used to bring guilt. That name used to bring doubt. The Lord is going to bring a new revelation of that name of Jesus. This morning we heard a powerful word about the power of the name of Jesus. So this morning, Lord, I thank you that in that name of Jesus, Lord, there is breakthrough even right now, Lord God, over old patterns, Lord God, because of the name of Jesus and the revelation that comes with the name of Jesus this morning. You were born, Lord God, so that we may have life. You were raised up, Lord God, so that we may have life. And we celebrate, Lord, this morning, that name of Jesus. Woo.
Some of us need to recognize that power of that name again in our lives. Amen. How many of you want to be set free this morning if you're feeling trapped? And this is nothing to be ashamed about. Jesus came to set us free. So if you want to be set free this morning from whatever has been holding you back, we want to pray for you this morning. Amen. Come on, be excited about the Lord this morning. Be excited about Jesus. Might have been something that happened this morning and it kind of just brought you down. Let the Lord lift you up today. Amen. The band's going to begin to play the song and we're going to sing. But I want you to come up and just let the power of God and the power of the name of Jesus begin to minister over you. Amen. We're going to lay hands.
I just want to speak to the onlineers just whilst the Lord's ministering and speaking to people's hearts here. Onlineers, I want you to stretch out your hand towards your screen. And those in the house, let's just pray in agreement for the onlineers this morning. I thank you, Lord God. I see someone sitting in their living room. In their living room, and the Lord is filling that space with God's presence and God's power. And I see a visitation that you will get. I see a visitation from an angel of the Lord, and the Lord will bring you and touch your mouth with a revelation of the name of Jesus. And you will not be able to help yourself but speak out the name of Jesus. And as you start speaking out the name of Jesus, your atmosphere is going to shift, and then your circumstances will change as you declare the name of Jesus. So I speak that out over you right now as you're watching. I don't know if it's on replay or live, but I know that the Lord is going to touch you in supernatural and miraculous ways. So if you need a supernatural, miraculous touch, people in the house this morning, through the name of Jesus, yes. I want you to come right now. Pastor Brandy wants you to come right now and stand in the front here that we can lay hands on
yes,
you
come on.
Very quickly, very quickly. Free. Come. I know that you feel an unctioning and a burning
yes.
to know that name of Jesus
yes.
again.
Come
to
on.
Know that name yes. of Jesus again.
Yes.
To know that name of Jesus
yes.
again. The name that saved you,
oh.
the name that has healed you,
yes.
the name that has delivered you.
Hallelujah.
This morning wants to do another
Hallelujah.
Work in you.
Yes.
In the name of
yes.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. In the name
yes.
of Jesus.
Yes.
In the name sure. of Jesus.
Barabasha. There is the rebirthing right now in Jesus' name over each and every single one of you. A rebirthing in Jesus' name. A rebirthing. A rebirthing. A letting go of the old. It's an identity that God is forming in you. An identity. Feel it rising up inside of you this morning. The name of Jesus that we speak over you right now. Shada, there's power in the name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, shada ba kara ba ba ba. Shera ba sundo. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Shaka bo so. Shara bo sundo ro bo sho. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Let's all sing this. Rejoice.
Peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus. Rejoice. The King has come for us. Receive what love has done. His name is Jesus.
There's such power here today. There is a different anointing. Different anointing. Prophet, even as we were uncovering the elements, I just felt this anointing moving through here. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he broke it. And he said, this is my body broken for you. And today we celebrate that Jesus' body was broken for us. We get to do this not as a religious act, but as a reminder of the power of the name of Jesus. What's in a name? Everything is in that name. Everything is in that name. My future is in that name. My past is in that name. My healing is in that name. My destiny is in that name. And because of this act, I get to celebrate that today. We get to celebrate that today. So don't just do it because it's communion. Don't just do it because you do it many times. But do it today to know what's in the name. The name. The name of Jesus. So thank you, Jesus, that your body was broken so that we may have life. And thank you, Jesus, that you shed your blood on the cross so that we may have life and that I may have life to fullness. And as we take communion together this morning, I want us to know what's in a name. Everything. Everything. Your identity is formed in the name of Jesus. So whether you call me Prophet M.M., Ricky, Mickey, whatever it is, what's in a name? Everything. Everything. But this morning, we get to take communion together as a family of Christ. So come, we're going to serve it from the two stations. Pastor Bran and I will serve you communion this morning. There is such an anointing here, I cannot tell you. Please come and fetch the wine and the bread and go back to your seat as we will take it together and have a moment where we say, Lord, everything is in your name. So come with family, friends, come. And have communion with us this morning. So we get to do this as a family, and I'm closing my eyes because I don't want this to be communion as usual. I don't want this just to be, you know, let's just get this done. This is not that kind of morning. Because we get to celebrate our King. We get to celebrate Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus our Savior, Jesus our Messiah. Thank you, Lord, that we get to do this morning as a family of God, Lord, united as one, Lord God, celebrating the name of Jesus, the name to which every knee will bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So this morning, we take of the bread and we say, thank you, Jesus. And I drink of the blood this morning, Lord God, and I say, flow, Holy Spirit, flow in my life. Flow, flow, rivers of living waters flow over us. As we take it this morning, Lord God, minister to us through this. In the name of Jesus.
Such power here today.
The word says in Ecclesiastes 4 that a three-stranded cord is not easily broken. And today, and the Lord kept on speaking to our hearts and saying, right in the book of Acts and in Philippians and through the prophets and the apostles, don't give up meeting together. But in all the day, all as you see the day approaching, stand firm in the unity of the Spirit. Continue to praise the Lord together and to take bread and eat together, to break bread together, and to stay in the unity of the Spirit. As Pastor Brand said earlier, you know, the enemy has done everything he possibly can this year to break people down. Individually and therefore the body of Christ. He has done everything in his power. But as Pastor Brain said, we don't focus on what he has done. We focus on our future. Hallelujah. The birth of Christ was because of the future God had set before us. Set your eyes on the future. If we don't, we have nothing to hope for. If we cannot believe that Jesus can save us from spiritual death, then we have nothing to hope for. If we don't believe that that name can break bondages and chains that have oppressed us, then we have nothing to hope for. But if we believe in that mighty name of Jesus, the name that is above every other name, that name will carry us through every struggle, through everything that we might go through, because it is a name that has power this morning. Powerful message, Pastor Brand. Powerful message. You got to go back and watch that message. There were so many important revelation in there that God wanted to speak to our hearts about. Some things I didn't even have time to finish taking notes for. You want to go back and you want to share this message with someone this morning. In fact, let me just do this while we're under the anointing. Those of you that are comfortable, don't do it if you're not comfortable. Just do it if it witnesses with your spirit. Take out your phones. This is a time I ask you to take your phones out if you don't already have them, or your devices. And if you go onto the Day Glory Family Church page, you should see, if you click on posts right at the top, one of the first things that comes up will be the live stream that we're on right now. If you are comfortable and you believe this message has touched you this morning, I'm going to ask you to share it. Just share it straight to your profile. It'll go straight and it'll go into the newsfeed, and somebody that is in need might see this, and there might just be somebody that needed to hear this morning that won't get reached through any of our normal channels. You know, we're one of the most active affirming churches on social media. I don't know that we can do more than we're doing. We're always willing to learn. But I want to say that the individual is still the one that reaches those for Christ before any organization. We are part of the body. So share this morning. Just take out your phones. And I also want to ask you, if you haven't checked into the church, it gives great exposure to the church if you just check in. Who knows how to check in? If you haven't checked in this morning, could I ask you to check in? It brings that name up. It gives us in the search. It brings up a wonderful, if again you're comfortable, if this is your house, check in. Let people see where you're worshiping this morning. Let people see that you're in the house of the Lord. And I just want to say from my side, it's just such a blessing to have you all with us here this morning, and that we're able to not just partake in the body of Christ together and experience the healing that comes under that name of Jesus, but that we can share in a Christmas lunch together, a meal together. And I want to just encourage you, even as we have lunch together today, go and sit with someone or speak to someone that you don't know. Go and let the Word of God just be moved among us this morning. And because we break every, you know, they say idle hands are the most dangerous thing, because people have time to gossip and break down the kingdom. But you know what? God is building it up. And those who don't turn their heads left or right, and listen, those that are being promoted in the church, those that are being raised up are always the ones the enemy goes for, because you're going to make an impact. And of course, he's going to come right at you. But you've got to know the power of that name. Amen. Amen. The power of that name.
Yes.
The name, the name that every believer can declare. And as soon as you say Jesus, you access that heavenly realm. Amen. How many say, listen, Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, come on, say Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. Give the Lord a shout this morning. Oh, yes. That amazing name. Hallelujah, Lord. We thank you for your word this morning. We thank you for its truth. We thank you for the power of that word. And Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, in Jesus' mighty name, we declare and decree that even over this festive season, every person in this place and those watching online and replay, Lord, that as you touch our lives, as we spend time in your presence, in our quiet time, in reading the word, that we'll let you minister into our lives, Lord. That we will draw off your word and draw off your spirit, making ourselves ready to hear and see what you have for us next year. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. And everybody said,
amen.
Oh, I can't hear you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a last shout. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Come on. Oh, that's not, come on, shout it out. Amen. God bless you. Are we done? Oh, the offering. You would think it was so unimportant, right? That I always forget about it. And I want to tell you, it's definitely the opposite. Not only do we need finance to keep the gospel going, to keep this place open, to keep the doors open, we know we don't give because of the need. We give because it's in our hearts to give. We give because Christ has put it in our hearts to understand the principle of sowing and reaping. We give because we understand that principle. And we give freely this morning. So whatever the figure is that the Lord has put in your heart, I want you to take hold of what the Word says and do that. Whatever's on the heart. For those that are locally in South Africa, we have EFT details over there on the screen. And those that are international, we have a secure PayPal that if you're on our Facebook page, you can click on it there, or on our website if you're watching from there. We want to just encourage you, though, please, church, be givers. If we want to be receivers of the word, we need to first be givers. Always learn to give, and you will receive more abundantly than you could hope or think. God will always take care of you. Amen. God's never failed me yet. Turn around to your neighbor and say, God's never failed me yet. Turn around to someone else and say, God hasn't failed me yet. In spite of me, God's not failed me. And now tell someone else, God's not failed you yet.
God's not failed you yet.
And say, God will never fail you.
God will never fail you.
People may fail you, but God will never fail you. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen, all I can tell you is this. When these kind of attacks that we've had, like we've never seen before, ever in the church happen, you got to know God's going to do multiplication.
Hallelujah.
Of things next year.
Amen.
You got to know it's going to be better than it's ever been.
Amen.
If we think it's been the worst that it's ever been, it's going to be better than it's ever been. Give the Lord a shout for that. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God bless you. The offering. Let's do the offering. Please come up and bring your offering.
peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, the King has come for us. Receive what love has done. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, rejoice. Peace on earth has come. His favor rests on us. His name is Jesus. Rejoice, the King has come for us. Receive what love has done. His name is Jesus.
Oh, we rejoice this morning, Lord. We rejoice at your name, Lord, and the power in that name. We rejoice at your word and what it says it will do as we follow you. And so, Lord, we take hold of all that you've given. And we thank you, God, that there is a multiplication, just like the loaves and the fishes, that is coming to this house. And I tell you what, as you sow into this house, which is good soil, you will see the multiplication coming into your life. There's not one person that I have seen walk through those doors that hasn't experienced radical change through their giving, as they've been obedient to the heart of God, because you stand under the covering and the house to which you hewn. And the scripture speaks clearly about that. And we got to do some more teachings on that, David. And so right now, in the name of Jesus, we speak life over these finances. We speak life over every person here. We speak life over every believer. We say, Lord, let these words that have gone out this morning penetrate the heart. Let everything that we have, every breath that we have, magnify your mighty name. In the name of Jesus, as we offer these small sacrifices to you that could never ever come near what you've done for us. No value can be attached to what you have done, but we give, Lord, from our hearts this morning. Thank you, Lord. We rejoice in our giving in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Please come and join us for lunch. This is so amazing. Well, you can have a seat in the can they sit down so long? You please come and have a seat. Go and have a seat. And everything will be ready in about 5 minutes. Amen.